Georgie Parker has arrived in the Bay. You'll never guess what she's up to.
You've come here to save yourself.
Seven's Home and Away is next.
Previously on Home and Away.
She needs education. She needs a routine.
I am trying.
Oh, really? Well, it doesn't look like
it
to me.
Stop attacking him. You're driving him away, just like Mom.
She's scared and she's lonely. Why don't you get in there and try and make her feel better?
Bianca, hey, it's Liam. I just wanted you to know that I haven't stopped thinking about you since I left. I'm in love with you. And if I don't hear back from you by this time tomorrow, then I'll know and you'll never hear from me again. Bye.
What was that?
Nothing.
That wasn't nothing. That was Liam. Okay, well, this changes everything. You can't marry Vittorio now.
Me and Vittorio are in a really good place at the moment and I don't want you to spoil that, okay?
Welcome back to Summer Bay, Ruth.
Hey.
Hi.
Can I help you?
No, I'm fine, thanks.
Oh, really? I don't usually walk around offering up my help.
Oh, well then, it's extremely kind of you.
Yeah, you're right. It is kind of me.
Especially when you don't know what kind of help I might need.
I'm just taking a punt. You know, you're standing in the middle of a caravan park with some luggage. I'm taking you. I might need a van.
Oh, God, no. No, my days of sleeping in vans are long gone.
Oh, yeah? Well, I mean, you don't look like a typical holiday maker.
Oh, yeah. Actually, I'm here to see someone, Alf Stewart.
Oh, you know Alf?
Yeah, you could say that. Is he at home, do you know?
Well, he should be doing the dishes considering he doesn't pay any rent.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, I'll see you later.
All right, bye.
Just a minute.
Surprise.
Ruth, stone the flaming crows. What are you doing here?
Oh, well, you know, last time you stayed, you left a pair of undies. I thought you might need them. Well, Dad, I'm here to see you, of course. I fly half the way around the world, and that's the welcome I get. Stone the flaming crows.
I'm sorry, I didn't know what to say. You're the last person I expected to see. Oh, darling, welcome home.
Dad.
You look sensational.
Well, so do you. There's a bit more of you, but you know.
Yeah, that'll be right. You're back for 5 seconds and getting stuck into me already.
I'm your daughter, I'm allowed.
I still can't believe you're standing there.
No, I should have told you I was coming, but you know, I wanted to surprise you.
It must be 20-odd years. What's the occasion?
Oh, a job I had fell through and I had some frequent fly points to use up, so...
Decided to come back to the Bay.
Yeah, I figured 20 years was long enough. I hope it's okay.
Okay. Of all the crazy stunts you've pulled over the years, turning up here unannounced has got to be right up there with the best of them. Oh, it's so good to see you.
Dad. We're late.
Ah. Oh, why don't you wake me?
What do you think I'm doing? I reckon you were having a pretty hot dream by the look on your face.
Mm.
Hey, can I borrow this?
Yeah, sure. And there was no look.
Yes, there was a look. And I know you're worried about something because you never let me borrow your clothes without an argument.
Fine, don't borrow it then.
This dream wouldn't have anything to do with a certain phone message, would it?
If you're referring to the phone message I deleted, no, it wouldn't.
You deleted it.
What else was I going to do with it?
I don't know. Listen to it over and over again until you realise you should call him back.
Grow up.
Fine.
Marry Vittorio. It's your loss. And I promise I won't get anything on it.
Get out.
Bianca, hey, it's Liam. I just wanted you to know that I haven't stopped thinking about you since I left. I'm in love with you.
I take it from your emails that your business is still going well?
Oh, yeah, no, I've been flat out. It's the first break I've had in a while, actually.
Yeah, it was. Good to know, Doc. And, what other news? Have you seen Duncan lately?
No, not for a while. But I did receive an interesting phone call a few months ago. From Martha. Now, it only lasted for a few minutes, but she wanted me to tell you that she's safe. She's with Hugo. I don't know where they are exactly, but I know that they have managed to make their way over to the States.
Oh, thank God for that.
Now, I would have told you sooner, but I didn't know if the police were listening into your phone or reading your emails.
Well, at least we know they're safe.
Yeah.
It's been a while, but I still really miss her.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I know that sounds strange, considering our circumstances, but it's true.
Doesn't sound strange at all, love.
Anyway, it's enough about me. So what about you? What's been going on here?
Do we really have to walk so fast?
I told you, I want to get there early.
Yeah, we're already running late. Well, you're so confused this morning.
I'm not confused.
Yeah, and you weren't dreaming about Liam. I'm right, aren't I? You know what? I can't believe it. You're having dreams about Liam and Murphy and you're still going to marry Vittorio?
I'm not doing this.
Yeah, I know. You're not playing this game anymore.
No, I'm not. Because it's not a game, April. It's my life.
But it's not just your life. It's Vittorio's as well. If you care about him at all, you'll at least admit to him that you're having thoughts about someone else. You'd expect him to do the same for you.
You're being investigated for a murder and you didn't tell me.
I didn't want to worry you.
Well, Dad, look, I know you have a lot of friends in this town, but it's not quite the same as family.
No. You going to get that?
No, that's nothing. Have you told Auntie Morag?
Well, there's no need. I've got nothing to hide. Besides, I'm not the only one he's having a go at. He's stirring up everybody in town.
Well, I don't care. Next time this Robinson comes around, you let me know, OK?
OK. OK. I've forgotten how bossy you can be. I'll just get that jug.
White and one, thanks.
Yeah, I remember. Somebody's stalking you.
Just a marketing company.
You look a bit tired, love. You want to go up and have a lie down?
No, I should try and stay up for a few more hours yet, I think.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you're going to do that, why don't we get out of the house, eh? We can go for a run around town, have a look at some of your old haunts.
Yeah, I'd like that.
All right, well, I'll just get rid of this stuff and we can go.
Oh, do you want a hand?
No, relax.
Rue, it's me. What's going on? I came home and you were gone. Where are you? You can't keep doing this to me.
Stuart, I'm calling on behalf of CPAC Limited to follow up our letters of June the 12th and August the 21st and to let you know that legal action will be taken in account.
Ms. Stewart, it's Jerry Goldstone from the bank here about overdrawn bank account 512.
That's my old homeroom in there. And your mum's too. I thought I was bringing back some memories.
That's great. Dad.
Oh, come on, Lou. You could at least pretend to be interested.
Hey, you guys made it. See, it's not that bad now, is it, Lou?
It's okay, I guess.
Okay. I know that starting year 7 can be pretty scary, but you can count on me to look after you.
Yeah, and Vijay, he'll be here next year.
That'll be cool.
Yeah.
Look, I've got to get to class, but you know where the office is, right?
Oh, that I remember too well.
Hey, see you guys back at home. Good luck, Lou.
Come on, let's go get some enrollment forms.
It's not our home.
What?
It's Irene's place.
Well, it can be our home if you want it to be. Iron said that's okay.
Our home should be with Mom.
Lou, Mom's got some things to work out. I already told you that.
No, you haven't. You haven't told me anything. I'm not a kid anymore. I'm about to start high school. Why won't you tell me what's going on? I don't want to go to this stupid school. I hate it. I hate you.
I knew there was something about you. I just couldn't put my finger on it.
So you two have already met?
Yeah, we bumped into each other. I had no idea. I was